Logitech's MX Master 3 and MX Keys has been marketed towards software engineers, content creators, and most recently, Mac users. Being the exact target audience and having used both these devices for the past 3 months, I believe I can give you guys a great idea on what it's like to own these devices. In this review, I'm going to be breaking it down into several parts. So if you want to skip on ahead, be sure to check out the description below for timestamps. Let's get started. The keyboard and mouse retail for $99.99 USD each. These devices are completely wireless and rely on a Bluetooth connection. They both come with a USB-C charging cable and a unifying receiver, just in case your device does not support Bluetooth. It's important to note, you only need one of these little things to connect both your devices. Considering I'm at my desk 12 to 16 hours a day, I've been very impressed with the battery life, having only charged each device about 3 to 4 times. First up is the MX Keys. The keyboard has a solid construction paired with a sleek, low-profile design. It features a white backlight for the times when you prefer to work in the darker environment. Weighing in about 810 grams allows the keyboard to stay in one place, even when typing aggressively. The MX Keys also contains all the media keys that a Mac would come with. There are a few extra convenient keys located right above the numpad. I personally find the calculator and screenshot button the most useful out of the four. The lock button could be useful in an office scenario, but I have definitely never used the menu button before. Both the media buttons and the extra buttons I just mentioned can be fully configured using Logitech Options software. The keyboard is unfortunately not mechanical, but does provide very good tactile feedback for quick typing. Let's do a typing test. With all these great things to say about the MX Keys, of course, there are some things I don't like about the keyboard. One being the lack of a numlock indicator. So if you accidentally hit the numlock key, you may be confused the next time you use the numpad. Other drawback of this device is the lack of separation of its function keys. Most likely this was done on purpose to match the MacBook and Magic keyboard. To most people, this won't be an issue. But as a developer, I use the F5 to F8 key rather frequently to step through code. And any type of physical indication on what function key you're pressing would have improved my overall user experience. Lastly, the keyboard sits flat with no options to adjust the angle, making it super uncomfortable when typing for long periods of time, suggesting potential ergonomic issues. To fix this, I just fold two pieces of paper and place it at the bottom of my keyboard to adjust the angle. You can also buy a third-party keyboard stand to fix the issue. I also bought the MX palm rest, which does help the ergonomic issues, but any other wrist rest would probably do just as good at a lower price point. Moving on to the MX Master 3. It's a highly rated mouse by most tech reviewers. The mouse weighs about 141 grams, making it the perfect balance between too heavy to move and too light if flies off your desk. It features a mag speed wheel, which essentially just means you can scroll super fast, but be super precise at the same time. There is also a thumb wheel for horizontal scrolling, which can be convenient when you have code that spans wider than your screen width. The back and forward button are located right below the thumb wheel, making navigation a breeze. My favorite feature of this mouse by far is the gesture button, which is located where your thumb usually rests. This feature combines the benefits of gestures on a touchpad with the accuracy and convenience of a traditional mouse. The MX Master 3 has very little issues, as it's a very solid mouse that has been through a few revisions already. One of the small issues with the mice is in order for you to manually toggle between paired devices, you need to flip over the mouse. The same goes for the on and off button. But this small issue can easily be overlooked, as you'll most likely be using the Logi Flow options when moving between computers. The main reason why I bought this setup is because of the impressive workflow that these devices offer. Being able to freely navigate between my desktop and MacBook has never been easier. One gesture is able to move both the keyboard and mouse to the next computer. I found my personal setup of having my Windows PC on the right and my Mac on the left works the best when using this workflow, as the close button for Windows is on the right hand corner and the Mac close button is on the left hand corner. This prevents me from accidentally going to the other computer when I'm trying to close a screen on the current computer. Screen corners can also be disabled to prevent this from happening. An additional safeguard would be to edit the trigger conditions of switching between computers from move to edge to hold control and move to edge. Another neat feature that this workflow offers is moving files between your two computers. I don't think there are any size limitations to this, as I have moved large video files over using this method before. In order for you to take advantage of this workflow, you have to have Logi options installed on all your devices. What this means is, even though you're able to control a phone and tablet using the Logitech mouse and keyboard via Bluetooth, they would not be workflow compatible because Logi options is only available for Windows and Mac OS. Another issue is the consistency of these workflows. There will be times where your keyboard and mouse just refuses to switch over to your other devices. Thank you for making it all the way to the end of this video. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. And if you want to see more of me, hit that subscribe button. If you have any questions on the MX Master 3 or MX keys, please feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll be sure to answer you. If you're planning to buy any of these products, my Amazon affiliation link is down below in the description. And if you have a spare moment, why not check out this video? Take care and stay safe.